Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to build my Lego Halo Warthog upgraded. My other videos, I had a large seat that was one piece. So I'm going to be showing you how to make the cockpit that goes along with the vehicle.
Okay.
First, you're going to need one of these pieces, dark gray. Take out the 2x2 that's right here. Add this right here. Then you need to take one of these type of pieces and put a stud on the front of it like this. I need to take a miles per hour gauge and add it onto there. So it looks like this. So it says it's going 82 miles an hour. And I need to stick that right here. But before you do that, you need to have one of these bendy type pieces. Not really bendy, but they move. And you need to put a 1x2 stud in the middle on top. And you need to add a stud on top of that. And on the top of the stud, you need to put a steering wheel. And then you need to add it on the driver's side, which would be the left side. I just realized something. My camera does the opposite. So, some like my picture part does. And then you need to add the one piece right there. Add the steering wheel up. And you need to take 1x2, dark gray or whatever. I need to add like some kind of buttons or something. And add it together. And then add it beside that. And you need to take 2 1x4s and add them on the side. And then you need to take 2 chairs. Add them like that. Okay, you're not done yet. The windshield is a bit different. The same windshield, add it on there. And then you need to take a 1x6 and add a vent or a flat piece in the middle. You need to take that and add it on top of the windshield. So it's a bit taller, but it looks a lot better. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to make the back part of my passenger Warthog. Okay, it originally could hold 4 people, but now it can only hold 2, because it was a bit not as much complicated. It wasn't as complex as this one. The other one didn't look anything like it, so just give me a second. I got inspired by, I think it was Tim Auber or something like that. I got inspired to do this. Okay. What you need to do is take a 6x8 and just set it on the ground. The 8 will be facing towards this way, which means it will be sticking out of the sides. So I'm just showing it this way. Now you need to take 1x2s with a stud in the middle and add them into the center. Then you need to take a 1x6 and add them on top of that. That's like the seat, sort of. Then you need to take a slanted 1x2 and add it right there. This is the back at an angle. Then you want to take this piece with a hole in it and add a blue stud type holder in the middle of it. You need 2 of these. And for the back, you need to add them on the sides. And take a 1x2 with two red studs for the lights on the edges and add them on there. Okay, then you need to take 1x4s, no wait, not 1x4s, but 1x2, and add them on the sides, and take 1x4s, and add them right here. And then you want to take two more 1x2s, and add them right here. This is what your basic looks like so far. Yes, I'm going a bit fast, so if you have to slow it down, you can. And then what you need to do is take a cylinder with a stud on it and add it to the this part. You need two of these. Then you need to take a 1x6 and add them on top of that. Those one black round ones I took out and added slanted ones. So it should be look a bit like this. You need to stick it right there. Then you want to add the same type of this piece and stick it on top. Trying to make this warthog a bit bigger than it already is. And you take this piece and add it on the back. Take a slanted... Oh, hang on. It's a miniature little slanted piece. Not sure if you can see this or not. Light gray. And add it on like this. Then you want to take a 1x3. And a 1x3 on the back of it. And you want to put it, let's see. Oh. Like this. On the back. And add a 1x2 right here. And add a 1x6. Piece and put it all the way to the front where it's touching the slanted and just put it down. We had to hold it on the bottom and the back. Yeah, it does that. So it looks a bit like this so far. Now for the roll cage part, you need two of these type of pieces. And I think you need to make it 1, 2, 3 clicks down. And you sort of need to bend them, turn them, so that they're slanted like this. So that they're touching the corners. And there you have it. There is your passenger. Well, before I do that, add it on there like this. And if I need to redo this, I can in my later videos. There you have it. There's your passenger warthog. You can only fit two in the back, but I think that's still pretty good. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It could originally fit four people, but these in the back weren't here. So... Okay, in the cockpit, you can't fit two people in there. The cockpit seating, you can't fit two people in there. Instead, you need to put the driver in there. You might need to put him on the other side. And on the other side. Oh, crap. Well, you put him in there. And you have to put one leg up and one leg down, like they did in the game, and add it on the side so that he's like sitting on the side